Hello and welcome back to this tutorial series on animating Genesis figures from Daz Studio in Blender with Rig-GNS. In the previous lesson, we looked at the functions of the buttons within the Animixer tab, understanding how it can be used to refine our animations. In this lesson, we're going to look at exporting the animation back to Daz. I have gone ahead and assigned additional animations from exam onto both characters. Now let me play the animation for you to see. Alright, that's the animation right there. Now, to export this to Daz, we'll begin by saving the project. Ensure your project is saved before starting this process, as exporting animations to Daz tends to mess with the armature. I will illustrate this later. Now, the next step is to reset the location and rotation of this character in object mode. So I'll press Alt-G and Alt-R to reset the location and rotation of the armature. Now that we have reset both the location and rotation of the rig, placing it back at the center of the scene, which is a crucial step before exporting, I will head over to the Rig-GNS panel. But before begin the animation, ensure to have the animation selected in the Big Action panel here. Once confirmed, then I'll go ahead and click the Big Animation button. In this pop-up option, I will set the frame rate from 1 to 1000, which is the entire range of the animation. Down here is a prompt stating Big Animation for Daz. This will render the rig unusable. I will go ahead and press OK. And then allow it some time to bake. Alright, now that the animation is baked, let me demonstrate what it means by rendering the rig unusable. When I select this bone and attempt to move it, you can see how the entire mesh gets distorted. It doesn't deform correctly, signaling the rig is no longer functional in its current state. So I'll go ahead and right click to cancel that. Now to export the baked animation, I'll go to File, then Export, and choose the BVH option. I will save the scene, renaming the file to Female Fight Animation. In this panel here, I'll specify the frame range to export. So for efficiency, I will just export from frames 250 to 800. With that set, I'll click Export Daz and then wait for the export process to complete. Okay, the BVH animation has been successfully exported. Now I'll click OK and then head over to Daz Studio. In my scene, I'll load a Genesis 8 female, but first let me set the view to perspective. Now I'll go ahead and load the figure along with the same outfit and hair as before. Now let's head over to File. But first, ensure the figure is selected in the scene pane, then go to File, select Import. Here's the animation we exported from Blender, Female Fight Animation. So once selected, click Open. In the Import options, make sure to check Limit Joint Rotation and Limit Translation to Hip, then click Accept. And now you can see the animation loading up on the timeline. Having the timeline pane visible is crucial for this step. Now that the animation has finished loading, I'll click this button to focus the view on the figure. I will also adjust the view by orbiting this cube for a better angle. Now let's play the animation. You can see the animation is identical to how it appeared in Blender. For a more detailed view, I'll switch the viewport to texture shaded. Alright, that's the animation. Sometimes the animation doesn't stick consistently on the floor. So let me go to orthographic right view to show you this. I will now have the view focused on this figure and then zoom out for a better view. To ensure the entire animation is grounded, I use the move to floor option, which is found here in Edit, under figure. You can find it right here. Move to floor. The shortcut key is Ctrl D. So my preferred method is to play the animation and then press Ctrl D at frames where I want the character to be on the floor. So that wraps up this lesson. In the next lesson, we will look at creating lip sync and facial expressions using the lip meter tab of Rig-GNS. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And for more content on using Daz and Blender for animation, consider subscribing to the channel. Thank you for your time. Until next time.